Elwood Richard Quesada was born as the first light of the air age broke over the horizon. As aviation soared through the 20th century, Quesada played a big role in the flight crew as innovative pilot, presidential advisor, and the FAA's first administrator. Quesada was born in Washington, D.C. on April 13, 1904, just months after the Wright brothers made their famous first flight at Kitty Hawk. Pete, the nickname Quesada carried for most of his life, was the son of a Spanish businessman and an Irish-American mother. Aviation figured little in his early life. In high school, he was named all-district quarterback and earned a football scholarship to the University of Maryland. He left Maryland for Georgetown University and graduated in 1924. That summer, while working as a lifeguard in Washington, he scuffled with an Army Air Service pilot. Once tempers cooled, the two became friends, and Pete was taken up for a life-changing flight. He joined the Air Service the same year. The following year, Quesada received his wings and commission in the Air Reserve. The young pilot found his career.
In 1928, while on a rescue mission to save a crew that crash-landed following the first east-to-west transatlantic crossing, Quesada considered how to improve on the idea of airborne refueling. Those thoughts led to a record-setting flight in January 1929. Quesada and four other crew members flew nonstop over California for 150 hours, which is more than 6.5 days. Without refueling on the ground. As a precaution, in case the plane fell apart in the air, the logbook was dropped to the ground each day. The question mark mission proved that air refueling could be an important part of air service tactics. It also established Quesada as an aviation pioneer, along with fellow crew members Carl Spatz, who became the first Air Force Chief of Staff, and Ira Eaker, who was later awarded a Congressional Gold Medal. After that path-breaking flight, Quesada went to Cuba as assistant military attaché. In the mid-1930s, he was chief pilot on the New York to Cleveland route when the Army temporarily took over airmail responsibilities.
From 1938 to 1940, he was in Argentina as a technical advisor to Argentina's Air Force. Throughout this pre-war period, Quesada honed his aviation, leadership, and diplomatic skills while moving up in the rank. During World War II, Quesada piloted many missions in the Tunisian, Sicilian, Corsican, and Italian campaigns. In 1944, as commanding general of the 9th Fighter Command in England, Quesada advanced headquarters to Normandy the day after D-Day. From here, the pilots general directed aerial cover and air support for the Allied invasion of continental Europe. Supreme Allied Commander Dwight Eisenhower personally chose General Quesada to fly him over the battlefield on observation missions. The bond formed then would be critical in the creation of the FAA 14 years later. After the war, Quesada commanded Tactical Air Command in the newly created U.S. Air Force and was a special assistant to the Air Force Chief of Staff.
In 1951, at age 47, and one of the service's youngest lieutenant generals, Quesada retired from the military after 25 years of service and numerous decorations, including the Distinguished Service Medal, the Distinguished Flying Cross, and the Purple Heart. He spent a year as vice president of Lockheed Aircraft in charge of their missile division, and followed that up as vice president and director of Olin Industries. During this time, the uncontrolled intersection of commercial airliners and military jets led to many fatal collisions. President Eisenhower and Congress had to act. Their solution was to create an independent federal aviation agency with combined military and civil air traffic control in the hands of one civilian boss. Quesada helped draft legislation that established the FAA from his position as head of the Airways Modernization Board and Eisenhower's special assistant for aviation.
Quesada was the president's natural choice to lead the new agency, and he was sworn in as the first administrator on November 1st, 1958. On the last day of 1958, the FAA assumed full operational status, absorbing roughly 28,000 employees from the old Civil Aeronautics Administration, 200 scientists and technicians from the defunct Airways Modernization Board, 26 rulemaking specialists from the Bureau of Safety Regulation, and 80 military officers from the Pentagon. Quesada served as the FAA administrator until Eisenhower's second term ended in 1961. During this period, the FAA integrated the National Airspace System for civil and military operators and oversaw modernization of the air traffic system. Quesada was generally regarded as a tough but outstanding administrator. Time magazine said in a 1960 cover story, "The great achievements of FAA's boss are proof enough that matters are well managed after years of slow deterioration in the government civilian flying agencies." Glancing skyward at the featherless creatures that fleck the clouds, the U.S. public senses a new confidence. Someone flying around up there likes them. His name is Pete Quesada.
Outside aviation, Quesada was one of the original owners of the Washington Senators professional baseball team and attended games with notables such as President John F. Kennedy. After leaving the FAA, Quesada was president of L'Enfant Properties, which developed L'Enfant Plaza off Independence Avenue in Washington, D.C. from 1963 to 1977. From 1973 until his retirement in 1978, he chaired a government-chartered body charged with encouraging the improvement of Pennsylvania Avenue between the White House and Capitol Hill. In addition, he sat on corporate boards and attended annual meetings at the Pentagon with the Air Force Chief of Staff. Pete Quesada died in Florida in 1993 at age 88 from heart failure. His contributions to aviation will be recognized forever.